I was on holidays, I was in Lanzarote, and somebody rang me and asked me would I be interested in doing the film about Wales and the Euros. I was incredibly excited about that because I'm a Wales fan. I was out there this summer as a fan, and they said there would be full access to the team. So I jumped at the chance, really. A guy called Grant Best, ex-head of BT Sport, and Ian Davis at the FAW, I met with them, and they gave me all the backing you could hope for. I mean, literally, they were fantastic. And then I went away for 6 months to an edit suite and made my my film. Well, I think a lot of people will tell you that the first game against Slovakia was our first game on a major stage in a major tournament for 60 years. And just in that moment before the anthem started, it was very emotional that we were there, you know, being seen by hundreds of millions of people across the planet. And Wales had never had such a high profile in a sporting sense. So there was it was a very emotional anthem, that first anthem. There were a lot of big grown men in tears, I think, at that point. So that was probably my most memorable moment, really. Was just before the first game when it was about to all start. I do know that it became very very tense in the table tennis tournaments. And Chris next to me, who became a very able table tennis player. But Adam Ramsey reckons that the players were just too nervous to take points off him. But they were always together. They were always doing films, watching films, doing quizzes together. So there was a feeling that, I mean, Gareth Bale said to me, a great line, he said, it was just like being on a holiday with your mates. I thought, what a lovely way of describing it, that they were like as if they were all a bunch of lads together. So they didn't want to come home. That's the whole point of the song. They didn't want to come home, and you really felt that. They wanted to stay together in France. They realised they were on this incredible journey, and all credit to them. They surpassed everybody's expectations. I had some fantastic interviews with the players. I had terrific match footage, obviously, but I wanted to incorporate the fan story as well. So I asked for lots of camera footage because there's so many people who've got cameras on their phones now, as you know. So I just asked them for lots of that, and that's what I tried to do. I weaved in this, this footage from the fans, so give their view as well, you know. And that's what the film is about, really. It's about not just a team story, it's about the fans and the nation's journey as well, from, you know, the start of the tournament where we didn't, you know, it wasn't a fan zone, I don't think, but by the end of the tournament where every major town and city was packed, you know, and everybody was waiting with bated breath for the game. Yeah, I mean, I've been asked to some festivals already. I've been asked to Berlin, I've been asked to one in Slovakia, I've been asked to New York, so Paris. So I'm going to take it around. I mean, I want to spread the gospel, as they say, and I think a lot of people, we became the story of the Euros, really, so a lot of people were interested in seeing the film because, I mean, Gareth Bale is a massively high-profile player, no two ways about it. But, I mean, the story of Wales also became the story of the Euros, I felt. So, yeah, I'm going to be taking it around the world, hopefully.